You have keratoconus, and you might have heard this 100 times from your friends or relatives. Hey, why don't you get that special laser procedure? Why don't you stop complaining about your vision all the time and finally just get that laser procedure, pay for it one time, knock it out, and you'll be fine forever, right? If it was only that easy, then we'd all be doing it if we have keratoconus. Let's talk about what kind of laser procedures you can do if you have keratoconus. So first of all, you might have heard of LASIK surgery. LASIK surgery is the most popular form of laser correction in the United States today. It involves reshaping the eye by removing tissue of the cornea and essentially flattening the cornea for most patients if they have high myopia so they can see without glasses again. Now the problem with doing that procedure is that it does thin the cornea significantly. And if you have keratoconus, your cornea is already thin to begin with. So if you did LASIK surgery on a patient with keratoconus, it might make everything much worse. So LASIK is out of the question. Now there is one in play though, called PRK. PRK stands for Photorefractive Keratectomy. That one doesn't remove as much tissue as LASIK because it goes more superficial. It doesn't go as deep. And that might be slightly safer for keratoconus. Now a few caveats though. Know that first of all, it's not FDA approved in the United States. Second also is that if you're going to do PRK, usually you need corneal cross-linking first. Corneal cross-linking is where they put the special eye drops in the eyes, shine ultraviolet light on the eye to cross-link it so it doesn't progress or get any worse. Afterwards, then maybe PRK is on the table. Regardless though, know that pursuing this type of surgery does carry a lot of risk involved. Do your due diligence. I would get a first and at least a second opinion to find out if it's right for you. Find out if your cornea is even thick enough to handle it, because again, there are significant risks, and I've had patients that have it done who've actually ended up worse off afterwards. I've had patients who've had it done who are all better off afterwards, but they still need to wear glasses and contact lenses. So know that there are certain expectations. Know that it doesn't just eliminate all your problems. There probably is things you have to do afterwards as well to correct your vision. As long as you are properly the right candidate, you have a thick cornea, you've got at least a second opinion, it potentially is right for you, but just go in knowing that information ahead of time. If you want to learn more about keratoconus and treatments for it, happy to share that information at our website. Click below at insightvisionoc.com.